The evolution of basketball is actually pretty hilarious if you think about it. Only 60 years ago, this is what it looked like. Something you would see running on loop in a museum next to a sarcophagus. Between then and now, the game has taken a life of its own, molding to the talents of its constituents, the desire of its viewers, the direction of its executives, and the feedback from its critics. At first, players operated at dial-up speed, slugging their way through clogged defenses using ball-handling tactics reminiscent of Stanley Hudson. To speed things up, they introduced a 24-second shot clock in 1954. All that did was give the most dominant individual players in the game's history more chances to treat defenders like the mere mortals they were. The three-point line didn't even make its debut until 1979. Soon thereafter, the age of dynasties began, including the 80 Celtics, the Showtime Lakers, the Bad Boys, Jordan. There was a decade of prison ball, no blood, no foul, with the scores frequently ending in the low 80s. That was until the Spurs resurrected fundamentals and ran every relic of 90s basketball into extinction, forcing big threes to form with the intention of drowning this dominant team play in talent. Super teams emerged as the king of the monsters. But as we all know by now, the hard part wasn't winning, it was keeping all of the basketball Godzillas together in harmony. As the empires broke apart, the age of duos emerged from the ashes, leading to competition parity the league had not seen in nearly half a century. And that's where we're at today. It's hard to believe, but you could make the case for almost half of the NBA winning the championship this year. Do you know how rare that is for the NBA? It's certainly not a March Madness single elimination tournament, but for an eternity, it felt like it was LeBron versus whichever dynasty formed in the West. This is why super teams are an endangered species. While their dominance was undeniable, the evolution of the game on and off the court proved rings just aren't enough anymore to satisfy the league's best players. And due to the sheer quantity of stars involved working under a hard salary-capped collective bargaining agreement, super teams outside of New York City, Los Angeles, and maybe Chicago will never have the same flexibility of financial legacy and marketing opportunity that the parity-driven NBA does right now. This doesn't mean super teams were a mistake, but it proves the desire to form them has waned. And like all the generational shifts of past, everything seemingly changed overnight. Coaches can challenge now. Positions 1 through 5 have become obsolete because everyone on the court can do it all. 7-footers shoot threes. It was against the rules for them to even dunk 50 years ago. An unstoppable move is invented, it's going to be copied almost instantly. If you try and manipulate the rulebook to draw fouls, the NBA's competition committee will dispose of your advantage in one off season. For the NBA this year, the next step forward is by taking one back. Back to the future, where the field has been leveled and stars will shine as a product of meritocracy and meritocracy only. The basketball will do the talking this year, and while that should probably be obvious, this is the first time in a long time that nobody has a head start.